I have a new dad joke for you. Why do teenage girls walk in threes, fives, and sevens?
I don't know. Why do they walk in threes, fives, and sevens?
Because they just can't even. Dad is here visiting me, so we thought since we're in the same room, we might as well make one of these question and answer videos. So we have a few new questions this week, and they're all air conditioner not cooling enough type related questions.
It's hot outside.
It's burning up outside, even right here on my deck. This one just came in one day ago. My AC unit is running and cooling is on. Ice is built up on the coils and nothing is coming through. They just replaced the capacitor. What could cause this problem?
Okay, like what we've always said about ice on your air conditioner should never happen. So don't ever tolerate it or think that it is cooling because it's not cooling at full efficiency. Couple of things. I don't know how related the capacitor is. I don't know if you've had blower issues or whatever, but there's two primary causes. One is the unit running short of refrigerant can put it in such a state that the causes the indoor coil to run below freezing, so condensation freezes on that coil. That's where the ice comes from. Or you've got an airflow problem across that indoor coil, like a plugged up filter or a dirty coil or a motor that's not running on the inside, but poor airflow across that coil. That and short of refrigerant are the two most likely. There can be variations of those two as well, but that's usually the case.
Another one, Kathy was commenting on our video where we were talking about air conditioner leaking water, different types of problems, and we held up a yellow pan treatment.
Pipe, the gunk that's in the drain pan that plugs up, we can treat that. We actually have a pan treatment. Most air conditioner tune-ups that we go on, we put a pan treatment in.
So she's asking, where do I find that piece you were mentioning, that yellow long strip you were holding? And I can just say, we'll link it down below. You can go to Amazon and get it, and so I'll link directly to it. But I wondered if this would be a good time to explain what pan treatments are for.
Right, and this is something we didn't always have pan treatments, but a number of years ago we became aware of them and actually used them for a year before we ever really sold that very many of them. But what we did find was they really work. And what they are, it's a treatment that goes in the indoor drain pan. So it's a semi-technical job to be able to put it into the proper place. So some indoor coils have covers on them that it's a matter of taking a few screws out, and then other times it's a matter of us making a cover to go over it. But what it is it's a biocide, I believe is the term for it, but over time releases an agent that cuts down all the slime and sludge that can grow in a drain pan. And you know, it's cold and dark and damp in there, and there's water sitting in a pan. So imagine what can grow in that pan. Well, it's a biocide that gets rid of all that, treats over time, so it's a slow release, so it lasts a year. And it virtually has eliminated callbacks when it comes to sludge, slimy drain, clogged up drains, you know, that kind of thing. It literally does away with them. And over time, we can look at the drain pan at my own home and see it is absolutely clean.
Right.
You know, so they work extremely well. Yes, call your local 1 hour. It's a very common part that we will perform, you know, during a tune-up. But we'll give a link as well if we can find another place where you can buy them.
Yeah, they have them on Amazon. I'll link it below so you can plug it in. But we find that people just making it part of their routine maintenance.
Yeah. I've also seen them in a tablet form.
Yeah.
Same kind of thing. It might be something you have to add several times a year. You know, you don't have that slow time release effect, but there's similar type things like that. Clorox bleach is another. So
MD asked this question 4 days ago on our video about air conditioner freezing, what to do. They are asking, turning the blower on, do you guys mean turning the fan only mode to help ice melt?
While you have the ice on the coil, you want to turn the air conditioner off. So the system switch, the heat cool off switch, is going to go to off. We do not want it running. And we want to turn the blower to on. We do want it running nonstop. And typically a couple of hours isn't usually enough to melt, but if it's in a really frozen up, it doesn't sound like this one is, but a few hours to to overnight, you know, to...
And as a novice person, I'm asking, so when you're saying you want the air conditioner off, but the fan or blower on,
right.
That would be the fan or blower down by the furnace.
Right, circulating,
circulating air, but the outside fan on the air conditioner should not be moving right. When you're doing this.
Right.
Okay.
You know, that's another very common thing. I don't want to confuse people, but it's another common way to get another common thing that can happen. And there can be a part that we've talked before about in the air conditioner outside. It's a motor starter, a contactor, you know, it's the switch that starts the unit up. There can be times where that can hang up and stick and not turn off the air conditioner. And so if your system goes through a normal cycle and it sticks, it can also cause the unit to ice up as well. So when you've got the air conditioner turned off at the thermostat, that unit should not be running at all on the outside. If it is, that's a problem sign.
Okay, cool. So, Dad, if somebody is having an issue with their air conditioner not cooling enough, like it's on and it's running, mm-hmm. but it's not cooling down the house enough, what would be something that you would recommend? Because we're getting this question a lot.
Well, we're going to stay within the realm of home ownership. What can the homeowner do? And the number one is check that air filter inside. We've had a couple of questions already, you know, this week about airflow, questioning airflow, or having issues with airflow on the inside portion of the system. So one is check that furnace filter, the air filter, and make sure it is clean. And then we're also going to want to make sure that the unit outside is clean.
Would you know, when we're talking about SEER rating, where can you find your average number of cooling hours for your area?
Average number of cooling hours, I would think you could just Google that.
Okay.
Average cooling hours, and they'll have a map with ranges.
Okay.
Let me try.
Well, no, that's okay. I have a better question for you.